Running and scheduling a report in VeraSmart 10. To run a call report in VeraSmart 10, log into the VeraSmart program. Depending on the user rights you've been granted, you may see several menu choices for reports, or just a few. Click on any visible tab and go to Reports, and then My Reports. This is your personalized list of reports based on your login ID. If your list is blank, you can add a report by clicking on the Add button. Select a report from the list. You can fill out the filter information and click on Run to send the report to the screen. You can also save your filter selections if you need to run a report more than once by clicking on Save. You can even rename the report under a different name if you'd like. Renaming the report will not alter the original report template. You can always retrieve a fresh report by clicking on the Add button again and selecting a fresh report. For best results, try using as few filters as possible. For example, if you are looking for all calls made by a particular extension, enter the extension used and the date range. There is no need to fill out additional fields. The more fields you fill out, the less likely you will find the data that you are looking for. The Layout tab allows you to change the field order and the field content of the report. To change the field order, click on the field you wish to move and either drag it with your mouse or use the arrows to move the field up or down to change the order. You can add or subtract fields by moving them from the Available Fields window to the Selected Fields window or back again. Please note that not all PBXs report data to these fields. Some fields are PBX switch specific. You may have to run a test report to see which fields actually contain data. Now you are ready to run the report. Click on the down arrow to list the run options. By default, the report will run to the internet browser or screen. However, you can also run the report to the report inbox or to email. The report inbox is located next to My Reports under the Reports menu. Let's run the report to the browser. The report will be created in a separate window. If the report fails to come up, you may be running a pop-up blocker in your browser. To bypass this blocker, try holding down the Control key as you click on the Run button. Once the report comes up, you can sort the columns by clicking on the column headings. You can also open the report in an Excel spreadsheet by clicking on the Excel link in the upper right-hand corner of the report. If you would like to email the report, click on the down arrow next to Run and select Email. Enter the email address. If you know the report has to be printed, you can select Print Friendly. However, by selecting Print Friendly, you will not be able to open the report in Excel or sort the columns of data. You will also have the option of sending the report as a link or an attachment. Under most circumstances, you will want to send an email link. If you need to email the report to someone who is not on your network, you can send the report as an attachment. The attachment is a zip file of the HTML text. To view the attachment in the report, the recipient will need to save the zip file to their hard drive and unzip the contents to a temporary folder. They can then click on the files to view the report. If you need to schedule the report to run at another time or at regular intervals, return to the report and adjust the date range for running in the future. For example, let's say we want to run this report on the first of every month. but we want the report to contain the data from the previous month. We would need to change the date range to run on last month. To schedule the report, we will need to save the report and then schedule it. By clicking on the down arrow next to the Save button, we can either save the report now and schedule it later, or we can save and schedule the report at the same time. I will save and schedule the report now. You will be presented with several scheduling choices. We will need to schedule this report to run monthly, starting on the first of the month. You will then be given an option to select the next run date and time. The default time is 1 a.m., however, you can change this time if you need to. Next, you will be shown several output options. We will run this report as an email link. You can type in the email address, or if you have entered email addresses into the VeraSmart system as part of the personnel entries, you can select the email address from the pick list by clicking on the search icon at the end of the email line. Remember to save your work. The report has now been saved and scheduled. The summary of how often the report will run and the next runtime are displayed next to the report name.